Welcome back. So in this episode, we're going to take a look at preferences and settings. If you followed the last episode, you may have noticed that I skipped this, describing what is up here. This is called the shell, and in this case, it's the Z shell or Z shell, however you want to say that. The reason I omitted that because I want to get into a little detail with it in this video and the next upcoming videos. So for right now, if you want to check out the preferences in Terminal, you would hit the command comma. That's a keyboard shortcut. I will tend to use a lot of keyboard shortcuts moving forward. It just makes it a little bit easier and a little more proficient than going up to the menu and selecting Terminal and then choosing preferences. Okay, the preferences tab will open up and it'll leave off where you last left off the last time you were in here. So in my case, I was in profiles. So it opened up the profile section. We're going to go to general and take a look at this fairly quickly. So on startup, when you open up the terminal, we chose this profile and it's called basic. If you click the dropdown, you'll see there's a list of other profiles that you can choose. And in this one, I created a custom profile for myself and I'll show you how to do that later. So you can choose any of these profiles. And as you can see, these profiles actually correlate with these profiles over here. So you'll notice that you get a visual representation of the profiles on this side and the custom one that I had created. Okay, let's jump back into general. And the next thing is window groups. We're going to skip this for now. We'll come back to it at a later point. And you can start up with window groups and I'll show you how to do that. The next thing over here is shells open with. And in this case, we're going to open with the default login shell. For us, depending on the operating system that you're using, that default login shell is ZSH. And I'm just going to give you a quick command just to show you the version. And in this case, we are ZSH 5.8. And we'll bring back up the preferences real quick. So that's our default login shell right here. If you wanted to switch out to another shell, you would choose this option. And this is the path to the shell. So if you were using, say, the born shell or bash shell or even the fish shell, you would just write where the path is to that shell. And when you open terminal once again, it would open up and you'd be using that appropriate shell. Okay, we're going to switch back to the default login shell. And down here, new windows open with. Once again, it's just pretty straightforward. The new windows open up with the default profile. In our case, our default profile is set to basic. And just a quick review, it says default right here. So therefore we know it's a default shell. If you were to pick another profile, you would be able to see that there's an option here for default. And once you pick the default, then that would become your default profile. I said shell, but I apologize. Down here is the default working directory. So for now, my default working directory is set to williamsk, which is my home directory, as we discussed in a previous video. So I'll show you how to change that if you need to. And then down here, new tabs open up with the same profile and same working directory. So if you open up a new tab or a new instance of terminal or multiple instances of terminal, they will start with the default profile, which is basic in our case, because we set that to default. And then it would open up in the same working directory, which would be in our case, or your case even, mine is williamsk, here might be your home directory, okay? So I'm just gonna clear this real quick, and then I'm going to go back here, and we're gonna take a look at how we could probably change this default working directory. Okay guys, while we're here, I'm just gonna show you a quick way to change the default working directory. Now there's numerous ways to do this, but I'm going to show you two ways. First one, we'll be going to our profiles and we're going to go to shell and we're going to enable this, which is run command. And the command that we're going to run is cd for change directory. I'm introducing this command right now, but we'll cover commands in greater details at a later date. And we're going to type in desktop. We're going to commit this by hitting enter. We're going to quit terminal, command Q. We are then going to reopen terminal in Spotlight. And as you can see, we have changed directories to the desktop, This icon is slightly different. It's the desktop icon. And we're going to reintroduce this command pwd, present working directory, or print working directory, however you want to say that. And this will show the current directory that we're in. Let's clear this. And there was a little bit of a caveat to this method. If we quit terminal and we reopen it using Spotlight, this command runs every single time. So if you don't want to run that command like every single time, I'll show you a way that you can put it inside what's called the zshrc file, which we created in a previous video. And that will just remove that command every single time when you run another instance of terminal. But to do that, we're going to use the terminal editor and we're going to type in nano, and we are going to modify this file. And as you can see in the previous videos, we've done some modifications here as well. I'm going to create a new line. I'm going to add a comment, and I'm just going to call this comment working directory. Okay. I'm going to add this command cd, and the same thing, we're going to cd into our desktop, and I'm just going to save this. So it's, if you're in here, it's control X, and then we're going to save our changes with Y, and then we're just going to hit enter to exit. Now, if we were to quit terminal, this would still show this command right here. So we have to go into preferences, and we have to go to shell, and we need to uncheck this, and then we need to quit. Then we're going to reopen terminal one more time. And as you can see, we're still in the desktop. We don't have that command being displayed. If we check our present working directory or print working directory, we have the same thing. This is very useful if you wanted to work in another folder, like I said, or a specific place, and have terminal open into that directory rather than its default. So if you want to remove that and just get back to normal, we will go back to this file here. We'll go down a few lines and we will just remove this. We'll go down another line and we'll also remove this. And we'll just save everything again. So control X, yes, enter, and it's removed. Okay, so we need to quit terminal, reopen terminal again, and as you can see, we're back to our default. So I know we're doing preferences and settings, and this is a lot to take in, and this will help you cover just the general tab that we've covered here. And we've dipped into a few of these other tabs, but that will give you a high level overview of everything you need to know about the first tab, which is general. Then we're going to move on to profiles. So just as a quick reminder, if you found this useful and you learned something new, don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment below, and hit the notification icon for future videos of this kind. Take care, guys, and we'll see you in the next episode.